All right, so now we're going to talk about the difference between the accrual and the deferral entry as it relates to an adjusting entry. Okay, so what I want you to do is just go ahead and start getting it in your mind that when we talk about a deferral, we're talking about a situation where cash is before. Cash comes before, all right? And then for the accrual basis, cash comes after. All right, so what are some examples? So when we're thinking about the deferral basis, some examples that we're usually gonna see, this is just typically, we're gonna have our prepaid accounts. Remember, a prepaid account, prepaid rent, prepaid insurance is an account where we said, okay, it's the beginning of the year. We know our rent is going to be $100 a month. We're going to go ahead and prepay that. We're going to pay $1,200 in January for the rent for the rest of the year. So that's going to be one of our prepaid accounts. Remember, that's cash before. Cash before we've earned it. Cash before we have the expense has been incurred. So we're prepaying something from an expense standpoint. So I'll just put an EXP right there. And then also, we have the unearned revenues. All right, remember, unearned revenue is kind of like a deposit or anything where the client has come in, given you money, cash, before you have done any work. All right, so we have not earned this money, so we have to put it, house it in this account called unearned revenue. Remember, just as a reminder, unearned revenue is a liability and prepaid expense is an asset, all right? So generally, most expenses are gonna be expenses, most revenues are gonna be revenues. However, these are two exceptions. The prepaid expense is always an asset and unearned revenue is always a liability. All right, so slipping over to the accrual basis. The accrual basis is when cash is gonna come after. This is generally kind of what we're used to seeing a lot of times in accounting, because what happens is we do the work and we're like, hey, we're gonna recognize our revenue. We've earned this money, so we wanna recognize it. That is what we call an accrual. On the other side, we say, we get to the end of the month, our utility bill is due, but maybe we don't wanna pay it yet, or it's just not time for our payroll department to process the check, not payroll, accounts payable. Our accounts payable department has not processed the check just yet. So instead of them actually going ahead and paying cash, we book it as a payable, and therefore it's an accrual because cash is going to be paid after the transaction date, after the time that is actually due. So over here under the accrual method, the thing that we kind of keep in mind is these are gonna be where our receivables, you know, I always mess that up. I before E, except after C. I do that every time. All right, so our receivables are gonna be here when we're talking about revenue. All right, and then also we're gonna have our payable when it comes to expenses. All right, so that's pretty much the short and sweet of it. If you can just remember that deferral are going to be situations where cash is going to come before, and then the accrual is when cash is going to come after, then I think you'll be okay. All right, as always, please leave comments, share, like, whatever, and just let me know. Feedback is always helpful. Thanks.